Okay, so this will be kind of the precursor video before the next GTO video comes out here in a few days, and the big Trans Am final reveal video where it's some driving and some, you know, some testing and stuff. This is mostly just to kind of show you what I've been doing for the last few days and why it's been a month since I've released a GTO video and, you know, this thing and blah, blah, blah. For starters, I finally cleaned the shed. I can actually walk, and I put the GTO back over there where the Trans Am was, because that is actually a better spot for it to be sitting so I can do the metal work. With it on the dollies, basically, I could still work on cars in this bay right here. I have plenty of room to get around it. This is actually a two-car spot, but the GTO kind of pulls into it a little bit. But I can work on stuff here, pull it in and out, but then whenever I want to work on this, I just roll it forward a few feet, and then I can get completely around the car. I've got tons of room to get my welder around it. It makes it a lot easier. I have started on the metalwork a little bit. I filmed quite a bit of it. I'm going to show as much of it as I can, because it seemed like some people were interested in seeing it. So that'll be mostly what the next video is.
Yeah, we'll have a true full update video on what's going on with that soon.
45 minutes long. The Trans Am, for today, I put new Nexen 165s on the fronts. Those are skinnies, obviously. I'm probably going to go to some type of street tire again. Not street tire, like regular street wheel setup where they're wide all the way around the car. I don't know what I'm going to go with. I bounce around so much, there's no point in me even telling you what I want because I change my mind every day. But I always lean kind of hard towards another set of laced wheels. I might even buy the oversized ones from Hawk Sturgeon or something. But yeah, I got new front tires on that. I've still got the drag radials. They're pretty old in the back. I need to do something there. So at least I can drive it now somewhat safer without maybe crashing if it sprinkled a little bit. Other than that, I did finally put a catch can system on this because before it had four valve cover breathers, basically circle track valve covers. So I put a nice little aluminum catch can over there. I have a little PCV check valve sticking out of my valve cover on the driver's side. And what that does is it'll suck the crankcase pressure out of that into that. That'll catch the liquid oil, and then it'll put the actual vacuumed air back into a 1-inch spacer that I put on top of the intake. I had a 1/2-inch spacer. I just went to a 1-inch because then I could put a vacuum port on it. So it's pretty simple setup. I basically just put a PCV setup on my car, which is positive crankcase ventilation for those of you that don't know. And I put a little catch can over there.
Just gets the pressure out of the engine, basically.
Yeah.
And obviously by doing that, he also put these nice valve covers on there.
Mm-hmm. Those are fabricated aluminum valve covers. I really like those. They have a thick flange on them. I think those are going to be a lot better. I also put a somewhat tacky, but I like it, 50 caliber bullet spark plug wire loom. I just thought it was neat. I saw it while I was on eBay, and I was like, whatever. It was like 10 bucks, so. But yeah, other than that, it's pretty much how it was. I hooked up my vacuum catch canister, so my brakes actually work because my cam's a little too big for my brakes that I've got. And
you also did mufflers to kind of quiet it down.
Oh, yeah. I put Flowmaster FXs on it, which they toned it down quite a bit. It doesn't sound anywhere near as radical as it did in that last video. That last video, I had what were effectively, you call them resonators. They were fake mufflers. They looked like mufflers, but they
drag racing glass tacks, basically. Yeah. But there's not much.
They really
to
had
them.
Three rows of perforated. They weren't actually mufflers. So these are real mufflers. They muffle it. They do make it more pleasant to drive, and it still sounds pretty radical when you rev it. It mostly toned down the idling in the mid range. It's not quite as it sounded kind of ratty sometimes here and there, but the idle is nowhere near as radical as it was, which, you know,
But when it goes wide open, it sounds the still same, sounds basically. Good, yeah.
And the other thing is this car has cutouts on it. It doesn't necessarily need to be crazy all the time because, I'll eventually buy the electric motors and put them on there, and then I can flip a switch and it'll be nuts. So having it toned down a little bit for driving in town and stuff, and it'll cut down on the neighbors calling the cops on me, hopefully. It's a sacrifice I'm willing to make because it still sounds cool to me.
How many miles do you think you put on it so far? Quite a few.
Not a ton, but I drove it around for about an hour the other day, nonstop, and I went out and did some pulls in it and rang it out pretty good. I've probably got, you know, a few hours on it now of driving around. I've done one oil change on it already. I'll probably do another here really soon. I'm thinking about driving it to work and back at some point this week, since I've got enough money to get a tow truck right now.
That's about a 130-mile round trip.
And I'll run the shit out of it on the interstate. So if it makes it back from that, I'll christen it and call it good. I did put a new black distributor cap on it, too, because I didn't like the red one. And I put a new coil in it and a new rotor. And I finally hooked up the Flamethrower 3 rev limiter, which I had taken out when I was trying to problem solve some things. I put an Excel in it because I was trying to sort out some little issues that I had. I basically just went through the whole ignition system. It wound up being like a loose ground or something. It was something like a really easy thing to fix. The ground strap shook loose from the back of the head, so I just put it back in and it was fine. So now I got my Flamethrower rev limiter back in that HEI unit, which is an MSD, and it's good to go. I mean, I've been using it and driving it around.
But real soon, you'll get the payoff video where we take it out on the street and, you know, do some burnouts, maybe some high-speed flybys, that kind of stuff.
Thanks to Illinois, I've lost the license plates I've had since I was in high school. It had been too long since I'd paid my sticker, I guess, and they were like, well, you need to get new plates.
So he's got one of those temp tags on the back right now after all these years.
On it that I've on a car I've had since I was 17. But whatever. At least I'll get the fresh new plates with the blue Abe Lincoln on it. So, but anyway, yeah, that's about it. I moved the GTO over there. My 68 GTO, the fast one that runs, it's good to go. It basically needs tires as well, which I'll do sometimes towards spring. I'm not getting it out in the winter. And this one has no heat and probably will never have heat, but this one's good to go. I've been driving it, so.
We might go ahead and fire it up and back it out the garage a little bit so you guys can hear it with the mufflers. And if we're real energetic, might open up the cutouts so you can hear that, but we'll see.
Hate us tonight if we just would quit right now.
Just for you guys, Jordan's gonna lay on the cold ground and open these cutouts so you can hear that.
They're not electric cutouts yet. I'm yet to do the electric part. Hopefully I get to that soon. Okay, so I got them open. The electric portion of electric cutouts must be really nice. I'm going to go ahead and upgrade to that soon, I think.
Yeah, that would be nice. I don't know if I should be in here. I'll go out here first, and then we'll walk in.
It's loud everywhere when they're open.
Sometimes when I'm further away, it actually sounds better. We'll see. I don't know. Fun. They want a little more concrete. This is that rough concrete out here.
Not anymore.
That sounds pretty good. Oh, it's man.
Some covered in mud a little bit. Hanging
around. Yeah, clean them off. That's why you did it. Sure, sure. Yeah.
All right. Anyway, that's enough messing around. Hey, it's 8 o'clock, not 4 in the morning this time, so that's pretty good. We're not even to noise ordinance level yet.
Yeah, I know.
Time. Yeah, we could keep doing this.
Yeah, we're never this early. It's crazy. I don't know. Why do we come in here where we can't breathe? Oh, there's tire smoke everywhere in here.
It smells like the racetrack. I need this. About this time of year, I start to really miss Gateway being open.
Yeah.
That's better. All right. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and clean up and spray some brake clean on that rubber outside. And, we'll see you in the next one. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. And see you later.
More craziness on the way.